Made a video about 2-3 hours ago talking about NBA 2K21 and talking about how the neighborhood, or whatever you want to call it, 2K Beach, whatever you guys desire to call it this year, leaked, and a lot of people were starting to see what it looked like. That was from a NBA 2K TV episode. So that was from what they showed us. They gave a little bit more of a sneak peek to what the NBA 2K21's 2K Beach environment was going to look like. We then saw that the rep rewards were revealed, and for some reason, I know not a lot of you guys did this, but a lot of you guys, when I make videos and I say that things leak, a lot of you guys just don't want to believe what I say, which I understand, because leaks aren't always necessarily real. But if I show video evidence of the actual rep rewards, I understand, like some of those Reddit posts and things like that, a lot of them usually aren't real. But this was video evidence of LD2K talking about the game and talking about 2K21, and then it showcased the rep rewards. Now, some of you guys said that that wasn't true and that the rep rewards were going to be different. I'm going to tell you right now with 110% confidence that the rep rewards are the exact same. And now I have literally 120,000% concrete proof that the neighborhood rep rewards are the exact same. And people were actually able to get on the servers and play NBA 2K20's neighborhood, play NBA 2K20's my career, my team, all of the online modes randomly went up today. Now, obviously, I cannot show you video evidence of this or I will lose my channel. So keep in mind that I cannot show video evidence. What I'm going to do is I'm going to link some channels where you guys can watch my team, neighborhood, and NBA 2K21 early in general. But I will show you some screenshots. You are going to be seeing screenshots all throughout this video of NBA 2K21 of the neighborhood, and there's going to be one screenshot of the stage. Now, I'm not trying to get anybody hyped up about NBA 2K21, because at the end of the day, it essentially is a copy-paste game. And you guys know me. If you've been watching this channel for a very long time, you know that I am very, very honest and upfront when it comes to 2K. I'm not that kind of person that freaks out because 2K added the new neighborhood and it completely ignores the fact that they didn't try on current gen. But I must give credit where credit is due. And visually, NBA 2K21, in terms of the park and the neighborhood and the 2K Beach, honestly doesn't look that bad. It actually looks pretty good in my personal opinion. Seeing this is very, very, very refreshing. Now, obviously, the reason why it's very refreshing is because we've seen the same park year after year. We've seen the same blacktop year after year, and the neighborhood really was the only thing they changed. Now, I was going to include my team stuff in these screenshots, but I'm not too sure if a lot of you guys are interested in my team. But as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I will drop you guys links to every single type of streamer. People are streaming my park, people are I shouldn't call it my park, people are streaming the 2K Beach neighborhood, and people are streaming my team. So I will drop every single person's links in the description below if you guys want to watch NBA 2K21 early. But like I said, I cannot include video evidence because I do not want to get my channel striked, and these screenshots are gonna have to do. So this is also a screenshot of the stage, but a lot of these screenshots, I'm not gonna lie, the neighborhood's looking a lot better this year. When I saw it, I'm just like, oh, it's a simple upgrade, it's not going to be fun, but it looks a lot more enticing. Obviously, when there's a new environment, people are going to want to play the game mode, game more. And I think that was a big part of the reason why people didn't enjoy NBA 2K20 and why a lot of people stopped playing NBA 2K20, because once you look at the same thing year after year upon for hours a day, obviously you're gonna get extremely bored of the game. Like, it's gonna come to a point where it's like, okay, I don't want to look at the same thing, because you looked at the same thing for 2 years in a row with a few minor changes. But this year, they actually changed it. It looks visually appealing. And I said this on Twitter, and I'll say this again, and I'll forever stand by this statement. I think NBA 2K21 was what NBA 2K20 was supposed to be. I feel like NBA 2K21 is a game where it's like, oh, we messed up on NBA 2K20. This is what NBA 2K20 was supposed to be with NBA 2K21. Now, there was a couple things I noticed when I was watching gameplay that had me very, very concerned for the concept of how NBA 2K21 is playing out. I watched a couple of minutes of a park game, okay? I want to say like 20, 30 minutes of people playing park, and then I went and made this video. But when I watched the 20, 30 minutes of park, okay, so you can't buy VC. So every single person that's playing a park game is a 60 overall. It doesn't even matter the archetype at that point because everyone's attributes are so low, but everyone is a 60 overall archetype in the park, playing twos, playing threes. I was watching someone play the twos, and I saw a 60 overall character in the park, okay, hit a 40% contested layup on another player with no badges. So immediately when I saw that, I thought to myself, this might be a rough year for gameplay, but it's hard to judge simply off a couple of incidences of people making highly contested layups, because obviously there's no badges, everyone's a 60 overall, I don't know. But seeing that 40% overall shot going in, 40% contested shot going in, I'm just like, okay, hopefully the gameplay is a little better than NBA 2K20. NBA 2K20's gameplay wasn't awful, but obviously there were a couple things that needed to be changed. I think especially the animations. But yeah, I watched the gameplay, and you guys can obviously be the judges for yourself in 7 hours if you guys live in New Zealand, or if you live in, I believe it's Australia, you guys can obviously judge for yourself. But people like myself and a lot of people watching this video who are on East Coast are going to have to wait until Friday. Like I said, I'm going to be leaving all the links to all of these streams in the description below, so you guys can go into the stream, say that I sent you, I don't really care, but you guys can watch, get your own personal opinion, because like I said multiple times, I cannot show video evidence of this or I will get myself in trouble. But with that being said, this video is going to come to an end. Before the video comes to an end, I just have a general question for a lot of you guys. I'm seeing a lot of new names in the comment section. Comment in the comment section where you guys are from. I'm actually very interested to see where you guys are from. I said that I was from Canada, and a lot of you guys are actually from Canada yourself, which is very, very interesting, because you don't really meet a lot of Canadians when you're doing Twitch or when you're doing YouTube. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to drop a like. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. Seriously, please subscribe to the channel. I am almost at 100,000 subscribers. The goal was to hit 100,000 subscribers before NBA 2K21, but considering the fact that NBA 2K21 comes out in under 24 hours, I think it's going to be very hard to get 7,000 subscribers. But if you're new and for some reason not subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. NBA 2K21 is going to be a great year for myself and for a lot of other content creators, so all the support is very much appreciated. But yeah, leave in the comment section where you're from, drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel. Hope you guys enjoyed it. See you guys next time. Peace.